Tom Seaver, a Hall of Fame pitcher and the hero of New York's Miracle Mets, who led his once-hapless team from the National League basement to an improbable World Series championship in 1969, died August 31st at age 75. The National Baseball Hall of Fame announced his death, noting that the causes were Lewy body dementia and COVID-19, the disease caused by the novel coronavirus. The statement did not say where he died. Mr. Seaver and his family announced in 2019 that he was withdrawing from public life because of advancing dementia. From the time he came to New York in 1967 as a 22-year-old rookie, Mr. Seaver began to transform a team that had been known as an inept group of lovable losers since the franchise began 5 years earlier. Enduring another defeat, the team's first manager, Casey Stengel, memorably quipped, "Can't anybody here play this game?" The clean-cut Mr. Seaver, who had been to college and served in the Marine Corps, brought an orderly sense of purpose to his pitching and to the Mets organization. In high school, the 5'9", 160-pound Mr. Seaver learned to pitch with finesse, precision and determination. Only later, after he grew 4 inches and gained 40 pounds, did he have the ability to throw the blazing, pinpoint-accurate fastball that made him one of the most dominant pitchers of his era. He is generally ranked among the 10 best pitchers in history by baseball historians. There is a good argument, noted the sports statistical guru Bill James, that Tom Seaver is the greatest pitcher of all time. Pitchers are among the most single-minded of athletes, and few are as devoted to their craft as Mr. Seaver. He always wore a long-sleeve shirt at the beach to keep his arm from being sunburned. When petting a dog, he used his left hand, not his right, or throwing, hand. He brought an intellectual approach to pitching that often led sportswriters to describe him as an artist on the mound. "Pitching is what makes me happy," he told Sports Illustrated in 1972. "I've devoted my life to it. I live my life around the 4 days between starts. It determines what I eat, when I go to bed, what I do when I'm awake. It determines how I spend my life when I'm not pitching." During his rookie season, the Mets finished in last place, a dismal 61-101, but he was a lone beacon of excellence, with a record of 16-13. He pitched in the All-Star game that year, saving a 15-inning victory for the National League. He was nicknamed Tom Terrific and the franchise. The next year, under new manager Gil Hodges, a one-time star with the Brooklyn Dodgers, the Mets improved. For the first time in their history, they didn't finish in last place, they were ninth in a 10-team league. Their breakthrough came in 1969, when they surprised the rest of the league, overtaking one team after another as they rose from cellar to first place.